this morning. Would you stand with us as we continue in worship? Declare that our fear doesn't stand a chance in Christ's love. He can be our stronghold this morning. Darkness tries to roll over my bones. Sorrow comes to steal the joy I own. Brokenness and pain is all I know. I won't be shaken. I won't be shaken.
2, 3.
My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. Shame no longer has a place to hide. Captive to the lies. I'm not afraid to leave my past behind. I won't be shaken. I won't be shaken. Yeah. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand. Again, we want to welcome you. We're going to take some time this morning to greet. Would you turn to those around you and greet in the name of our Lord Jesus?
staff pastor here at Crossroads. Welcome you this morning. If you're new, I especially want to take a moment to welcome you. I'm so glad you're a part of this gathering and do welcome you this morning. If you are new, I would invite you. One of the first steps to begin to connect into the life of Crossroads is simply filling out the orange Connect card. It's in the chair pocket in front of you. So if you are new, if you would take a moment to pull out that orange Connect card and fill that out sometime during this gathering. And then if you would take a moment right after this gathering to stop by a place we call Starting Point. It's just out these doors and to the right. We would love a chance to meet you. We have a gift for you this morning, and we're just so glad you're here.
Candles and the piano are so smelly.
I'd also mention in the chair pocket in front of you is also a prayer card. If there's ways that we can be praying for you or answers to prayer that we can celebrate with you, if you want to take a moment to jot those down, and you can drop that in the offering plate here in just a few minutes. I'm excited about an event that's coming up in April. I know that's a little ways off, but I want to tell you about it. It's our Easter egg hunt. It's a huge outreach event. It's on Saturday morning, April the 20th. From 10 to 12 with an egg hunt at 11. Going to be a great event. There's going to be so many on our campus. There's going to be inflatables, waffle truck, petting zoo, the egg hunt, so many. It's going to be great. And here's why I'm telling you about it a little bit early, is I would ask you to begin to think now of who you might invite. Maybe there's someone you work with or neighbors or family or friends that have children elementary age or early childhood that would this would be great for their family. They're looking for something. So I'd ask you to begin to think about now who you could invite. And then also, I'm asking you, there's a number of ways you can be a part. There's going to be over 5,000 eggs at this Easter egg hunt. And we need your help in a number of ways. I mean, it's going to be huge. Kids that come are going to leave with a lot of eggs. They're going to have a great time. But we need your help with candy, individual wrapped candy for those eggs, bottled water. So if you can bring those items over these next weeks and just drop them off at the Family Ministry kiosk. I saw a lot of cases of bottled water out there this morning, but if you bring that, it's going to be in April, so it'll be maybe a little bit warm outside. And then also, I need your help in a few different areas. Stuffing the eggs on Wednesday, April the 10th, prepping the field on Friday the 19th, and then the day of the egg hunt, we're going to need a number of volunteers. And here's what you can do. Go to crnaz.com/egghuntvolunteer. And it's simply clicking on a few boxes of what time slots and where you would like to volunteer. But love for you to be a part of it. If you have questions, stop by the Family Ministry kiosk this morning. They'll help you out, answer your questions. But we're looking forward to that event, and I hope that you'll jump in and that you'll be a part. A number of other things going on in Life of Crossroads, so I would encourage you some places to go for information. One is our online community, crnazonline.com. If you haven't joined us, love for you to be a part of that. Also, the bulletin that you have in your hands, hopefully you got one as you came in this morning, check that out. There's information there. And then the third place would be, if you have questions, the kiosk underneath the Ramada is the place to go. We have people there that would love to answer your questions. So if you would take a moment, if you do have questions, to stop by there, we'd love to help you out this morning. I might have our ushers at this time prepare to come forward to receive our morning tithes and offerings. As they do, I'd remind a number of ways you can give. Text give, online, here on site, either in the offering plate or the offering bins at the back of the room. Thank you for your generosity and for the way that you give. Let's go to the Lord in prayer together this morning. Lord, thank you for your love for us. That we don't have to walk in fear, but we can have hope. Because of your presence. That you walk with us. That you're a God that walks beside us, that goes ahead of us. That you surround us, and we thank you for that. We look to you this morning as we worship. We give you the praise that you're worthy of. Lord, this morning as we gather, we also think about the families of the Christchurch mosque shootings. And Lord, we pray that you would bring comfort to those that mourn this morning, who have fear and are calling out, looking for answers and for hope. Lord, I pray that you would come to them, that they would know of your love, of your life, death, and resurrection, the hope that they can find in you. Lord, I pray that you'd help us as a people, that we would stand against hatred and racism. That we'd be a voice for your love and your grace. Lord, thank you for your love for us. We celebrate that this morning. We look to the cross as it's our central to our worship this morning. Savior that loves us and sent his one and only Son that we may have life we look to you. Lord, I pray that you'd help us as we worship you, that we would allow your Spirit to work within us and continue to do the work that you desire to do, that we might be fully yours. Continue to shape us and transform us, and teach us this morning as we worship you, as we worship you in song and as we look into your word, that you would shape us. Lord, as we worship you in giving this morning, as we bring a tithe, which is yours, and offerings, we pray that you would bless these gifts. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Intro 2, 3, 4.
In the name of Jesus.
direction this morning. The cross as the final word. The cross as the final word. Sorrow made the darkest night. The cross as strength in whom I will trust, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. We declare this morning. We claim the name of Jesus, his resurrection, his life. We sing this out. There's nothing stronger, nothing higher, nothing greater than the name of Jesus. All the thank you. sing it out.
Jesus, my Jesus, for your glory, for your name. Jesus, my Jesus, I will only sing your praise.
Jesus.
You want to say to us today. God, I pray you'll help me to say and be what you want. May the words of my mouth and meditations of my heart be pleasing you, O God, my rock and my redeemer. And I'll ask all these kind favors in Christ's holy, holy name. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. So this is the second Sunday in Lent, and we are marching through 40 days of repentance and 40 days of reflection